It's been a long, long road with Ashlyn a little over 2 years ago. She had issues with her heart. Then she started to have what we call these little spells, and we just didn't know. And she basically turned blue and just stopped breathing. And when she was 2 months old, she went into cardiac arrest. I actually resuscitated her, did CPR on her. They put a pacemaker in her the very next morning. She wasn't eating, so we ended up taking her back to the hospital again, ended up putting the feeding tube in. But we went literally a year before we ever found out that she was diagnosed with mitochondrial disease. They have not found another child in the United States that has the same components of this that she does. It tested our marriage, it tested, you know, everything with our family. The thing that's hardest for me is with my employers. You know, they all say they understand, but they eventually end up letting me go. But we have a strong faith in God, and you know, the church has always been here for us and helped us through a lot of these dark times. So.
2 weeks after coming to Calvary Chapel, Ashlyn was due to go in for surgery, and I was petrified. I sent an email on the website requesting prayer requests. That night, Pastor Sean called us at our home.
I receive a lot of emails about benevolence and people with needs and what have you. For some reason, the Lord really laid this family in my heart when I first received an email from Jessica. I felt that the Lord was calling me to do whatever, pull together whatever resources I could from the church to be able to help this family.
That's truly what touched me more than anything, was the response, the attention that we got from the church.
Certainly, spiritually, you know, we've prayed with them, we've come alongside them, we've done lots of things to help them spiritually, but also practically, because in situations like that, there are a lot of practical needs that have to be met. I mean, there's medical bills, of course, but there's also difficulties with just the practical things of rent, power bills. It's heartbreaking to look into the eyes of their children and know that, you know, there could be nights where families are going to bed cold. Children are sleeping in cold rooms, and I want to do whatever I can to help facilitate that not happening.
And that's when they started just really opening up their arms to us and really showing us God's qualities and characteristics.
There's so many people that are without, and so we just decided to call the church and to see if they had a family that they knew of that might have some needs that we could meet this season to hopefully make someone's Christmas a little bit better this year. So we found a family that could use our help, and we're just going to try to help them.
I remember not being sure whether or not we'd have heat, living off cheese that the government provided. And I haven't had to worry about that in a long time. And I want to make sure, my wife and I and my two daughters want to make sure that this family doesn't have to worry about that this Christmas.
Pastor Sean actually called John and asked him if they could sow some blessings into our lives for Christmas, and to even offer to do that for us was so many things: unbelievable, an answer to prayer, unexpected. That's okay, honey. Generous, loving, kind. I mean, I could go on and on. And
I'm not sorry.
Honey, you're all right. And, you know, we just... just in shock and truly grateful.
More than just buying their physical needs, more than just giving them money or giving them items, we want to give them the love that Christ gives us and really, you know, put our arms around them, pick them up, and make them a part of our family.
Being here and being under Pastor David's teaching, you know, you just realize that this world is very fleeting, and if we can reach out and make a difference and point somebody toward Jesus and bless them, then that service, I mean, that's the greatest gift that we can give.
Go out there and meet somebody's needs. You may know them, you may not, but find a need and meet it.
I cannot emphasize that enough, that you can truly see the Spirit of God and truly see what makes God proud and see the qualities that God wants His church family to have, and that is here at Calvary Chapel. We can't say thank you enough. I mean, thank you, it doesn't seem like it's enough, and we can't express our gratitude and our love.